I have given priority to the provision of electricity, not only for the capital city of Freetown, but for all the provincial headquarter towns. This objective will be difficult to achieve if we do not change our attitude. I am emphasizing this point because no matter what efforts we make, all our labor to improve the electricity situation in the country will go in vain if we continue with the same negative and destructive attitudes. Just as the attitude of some of our compatriots towards efforts to improving electricity supply has been irresponsible, so it has been with the attitude of others towards government property. In the recent past, vehicles donated to the nation to improve transportation have been vandalized, and government and donor resources intended to relieve our people from deprivation and want have been diverted from the purpose for which they were intended. Such behavior does not only show a lack of patriotism, personal discipline, and self-respect, but is also detrimental to the efforts to bring peace and prosperity to our country. Surely our goal for eradicating poverty cannot be achieved if we continue to engage in such destructive activities. I therefore call upon those of my fellow citizens responsible for these acts to make a radical break with their present behavior and bring about a fundamental change in their attitude for the benefit of our nation. I have reiterated on several occasions on assuming the presidency of our nation that I will exercise zero tolerance towards corruption. However, unless we change our attitude, my determination to stamp out corruption from our land will be fruitless, and we will not achieve our goal of a developed and prosperous Sierra Leone that we collectively wish for. I emphasize this point because corruption is not only a matter for the leaders and heads of government institutions, it is equally a matter for everybody. A critical examination of the way of life indicates that corruption lies in our attitude, and unless we change our attitude, we shall never be able to create the peaceful, progressive, and prosperous country that we dream about and wish to build. To bring this change, however, it is not sufficient merely to hope for it. We must be actively involved in making sure that the changes we desire are effected. As I mentioned earlier, fighting corruption is a matter for all of us, not the leaders alone. This occasion today should therefore present us with a glorious opportunity to renew our commitment towards fighting this menace. But we shall never conquer corruption unless we change our attitudes. As the saying goes, attitude is everything. Change your attitude, you change your life. What is true in our personal life appears to hold true for the nation as well. We must therefore be willing to change our attitude towards our nation if we want our country to move forward. Another area where we need to change our attitude as a nation is how we deal with our children, youth, and women. Children and youth constitute a substantial segment of our population of Sierra Leone, and it is estimated at about 67% of our total population. Sierra Leone youth and children were already disadvantaged even before the outbreak of the war. The 11 years of brutal war, which specifically targeted the children and the youth of this country, just worsened their situation even more than the pre-war period. Today, in spite of the efforts to improve their condition, a large number of them still suffer from inadequate educational facilities and opportunities, shelter, food, health, and recreation facilities. Children and youth are valuable national assets, and we should have a more sympathetic attitude towards them and do everything possible to help them develop their talents and protect them from harm if they are to contribute to our national development. Women are easily the most valuable assets, and we as a nation appear to have failed sufficiently to recognize that. That constitutes a significant population and add up to more than 51%. They are principally responsible for the development of our children, our future leaders. According to the findings of the Beijing Conference of Women in China in 1995, women contribute more to the family income than men. The women are our first and best teachers, and this function starts before and immediately after birth. As a result of the atrocities committed during our 11-year war, many people are maimed, abused, and disabled. Our attitude to these unfortunate groups have not been helpful, and many of them still live in difficult circumstances.